Now, in the famous movie of 1995 called Die Hard with a Vengeance, starring Bruce Willis and Samuel Jackson, you probably recall that there was a problem where they needed to find somehow 4 gallons, and they had a 3 gallon and 5 gallon tank available, so they needed to derive somehow 4 gallons of water. So this is exactly what this problem asks you to do, and it's a really fun problem to take a look at it. There are two ways of solving it. So you have two tanks. One tank can be completely filled with 3 gallons of water, and the other tank can be completely filled with 5 gallons of water. You need 4 gallons of water. How would you proceed? So the first way, we're gonna first fill the 5 gallon tank. So both of them are empty in the beginning. So we're gonna fill the five gallon tank. And by the way, these are not gonna be the tanks that you're gonna see, right? Because you can easily just calculate the numbers. You will have to see them this way most likely, and that's what the movie showed you, right? The tanks do not look remotely similar, and they're not numbered in this way. And even if they were numbered, it would be hard to, you know, to actually calculate precisely how, you know, how much water that you're pouring out and in of the tank, right? So these will be the realistic looking tanks that you're gonna have in that scenario that you saw in the movie, right? So in this case, just for purposes of the procedure, right, just to see how this problem can be solved, you see these numbered tanks here, right? So we first fill the 5 gallon tank completely. Then what we do, we're gonna fill the 3 gallon tank using this filled 5 gallon tank, right? So we're gonna pour water from the 5 gallon tank into the 3 gallon tank, right? So we're gonna make it full. Thus, we're gonna empty the 5 gallon tank, right? 2 gallons of water will, 3 gallons of water will not be there anymore, right? So 2 gallons of water are left in the 5 gallon tank. The next thing is to empty the 3 gallon tank. So we empty the 3 gallon tank. And next we're going to empty the 5 gallon tank, whatever remains, in this case is 2 gallons. We're going to pour 2 gallons of water left in the 5 gallon tank into the empty 3 gallon tank. Right, so what this does, this fills the 2 gallons into the 3 gallon tank, and it leaves the 5 gallon tank empty. Right, so now the 3 gallon tank has 2 gallons of water filled and 1 gallon of water left to fill, right? One-thirds empty. So now we're gonna fill the 5 gallon tank completely again, right? We're gonna fill it up, and now what you're gonna do is you're gonna fill up the 3 gallon tank using the 5 gallon tank, right? So you're gonna fill it up using the 5 gallons, so you have 1 gallon empty in the 5 gallon tank as a result. So what do you get? 4 gallons of water. If you remember in the movie, they were given maybe less than a minute to really think about how to solve this problem, right? So you have to use either way that works. So first we're gonna fill up the 3 gallon tank, and we're gonna empty it completely into the 5 gallon tank, right? So we will have 3 gallons inside the 5 gallon tank, right? And we're gonna empty the 3 gallons, the 3 gallon tank completely, right? So we're pouring all 3 gallons in from the 3 gallon tank into the 5 gallon tank, right? So what happens after that? We're gonna fill the 3 gallon tank once again, and we're gonna pour 2 gallons of it. In other words, we're gonna fill up the 5 gallon tank completely using this completely full 3 gallon tank, right? So we're gonna have a full 5 gallon tank. So 2 gallons will be taken out of the 3 gallon tank, right? So 1 gallon tank remain, 1 gallon remains in the 3 gallon tank. So we're now gonna empty, right? We're gonna empty the 5 gallon tank, and we're gonna pour this remaining 1 gallon from the 3 gallon tank into the 5 gallon tank, right? So it's gonna be 1 gallon full, right? And this one will be empty. So now what happens is we fill up the 3 gallon tank completely, and then we simply pour these 3 gallons into the 5 gallon tank, and we empty it that way, and as a result we will have 4 gallons of water inside the 5 gallon tank. So as you can see, this is pretty elegant. You have two different ways of doing it, but they're so much fun. I mean, this is so much fun to do. And I hope that you watched this movie if you didn't yet. You know, specifically that moment was a lot of fun to watch because they had less than a minute to think about the solution. And even if they were nervous, they still did it. And, you know, they did it together. That was amazing. So I hope you guys found this a lot of fun, and see you in the next videos.